Chef for the former chef for the White House, an exclusive chef for the Hay Adams, did this cake for you guys. Her name is Kendall Case. Excellent.
Yeah, exactly. You guys got a smile, right?
Yeah. Hey, look, that
way. Smile.
Come on, make some
funny shots. Where's the saxophone, Pete?
Oh, it ain't far. I'm probably going
to
get us.
Do we have to pay taxes on these kids?
No. No taxes.
Like a new reality show.
Flex Club.
That's me, but...
We don't do porn.
That's just Skis movie
in
Malawi.
That's the first I heard of it.
And he had to do it in Malawi because the things he's doing are illegal in here.
We know nothing about the adventures.
Double fisting is illegal here. They're doing us. This is the DVD, and it's airing on CBS on Friday. Yes, they're having a big. Right. They're having a concert. I'm sorry, I'm an artist. They're having a comedy show, and they're having a premiere of the DVD on CBS.
And people were asking me, why is our special airing at 1:30 in the morning? It's because of the content of it. You can't. Certain laws, this is broadcast. They got us on broadcast television. This isn't cable. It's hard to get. When's the last time you saw a stand-up comedy special on broadcast television?
Right.
It just doesn't happen.
Right.
Because you got more people watching broadcast television than pay channels. So in order to get a stand-up comedy special on broadcast television, you have to be on at a certain hour of night so that the content and the subject matter is not deemed inappropriate.
Yeah, so basically you're going to hear,
I mean, but the DVD is excellent. I mean, the
these mortal
wounds. Y'all ain't seen it. You know what I'm talking about.
Are you talking about this DVD or your DVD?
No,
that's Malawi.
Yeah, that's Malawi.
You know what I'm talking about. But great DVD. It's a great DVD. I've known these guys for years, back in the days of Mr. Henry.
50 Shades of Ski.
Mr. Henry. This guy I met at Mr. Henry's, and over the years I've seen him, and it's just an honor to work with him and be a part of what they do. I'm fans.
We're fans also, bro.
As well as, you know, I love these guys, man. And I'm going to say this on the record, they've never changed. Always been the same. Some people change. They've never changed, always been the same. Great guys.
Yeah, and we're never going to change. We've been promoting this DVD for a year. Our team, Ski Johnson's team, we've been promoting it for a year. And now it all comes to this Friday where we do the actual DVD release premiere party. And we had to do it in D.C. Even though Tom Joyner is nationally syndicated,
right. We're
like in over 70, 80 markets, 8 million listeners a morning. But got to come back to D.C. where we shot it, where we're from, where... our homes are, and we're going to have a big party, and then it kicks off after the comedy show. Our DVD makes its debut on network television on WUSA Channel 9 in D.C. at 1:30 in the morning. So we're focused on that.
Well, that's great. That is great news. Everybody's excited about this. Waste TV, of course, is excited.
Are you excited, bro?
Oh, yeah.
Are you really excited? You sound like you're excited, bro. Waste TV is really excited. Definitely. I'm going to get a whole lot of 5 hours. We need a 5-hour energy drink over here. Somebody got a Viagra?
Give us a drink. But that's not to say we don't have the stuff going on. I mean, Huggy is still we're on tour still around the country, doing stand up everywhere. But and Huggy's still on the road making promotional appearances for TV One. You know, he was a co-star of TV One's hit sitcom Love That Girl. It's his first sitcom. We're all very, very proud of him.
Playing myself.
Yeah.
It was hard. On TV, like transition from radio, they went, cut! I'm like, you playing you?
Exactly.
The show is extremely popular, but unfortunately, the show has been canceled only because.
Hold on, you could have tweeted.
You didn't know?
I didn't know, bro.
No, because a lot of the major players of the show, their contracts were not extended in time for them to get snatched up by Kevin Hart's production company, so they're going to be doing sitcoms with Kevin Hart.
Okay.
So, but that's still, it was a great way.
Once again, the comedian, Kevin Hart.
Right, Kevin Hart came and snatched up
our stuff. And I'm sorry to interrupt, but Chris Fall did the writing for the show.
Uh-huh.
Am I right, correct?
Yes.
Not all of it. Okay, well, some of that stuff ain't funny. Don't give me credit for that. And funny, I wrote it.
He said he did the funny stuff.
And I want to make a note that he's an Emmy winner.
Yes, Emmy Award winner.
I was gonna say that. We just kicked off our I've been hosting a television show for the Washington Redskins. Sports and comedy are both my passions. Right. So it's my 10th season hosting a Redskins late night comedy show called Redskins Late Night. It's the only show like it in all the sports where we do sketch comedy, interviews with players, we do music, our own produced music videos, and it's our 10th season. We're currently the longest running Redskins show on television in the DC market. So.
You just mentioned Kevin Hart. Are there other comedians that you're looking forward to doing collaborations with in the future, or how's that panning out?
Oh no, we would love to work with anybody. We've known Kevin for years. Right. We've known a lot of guys for years.
Comedy strumpets.
Yeah.
I had to use that word, strumpet.
But honestly, it's crazy. I mean, Huggy and I really just kind of stay in our own pocket. You know, we don't. And we got love for everybody, but we don't cross paths with anybody. We're just where we are, doing what we do. You know, we're still here, based out of Washington D.C. That's the blessing of being on Tom Joyner's show, syndicated. Being syndicated.
Right.
I do stuff from my studio. He does stuff from his studio. So,
exactly.
But we'd love to work with anybody.
Okay, great. Well, look.
Can I ask a question about the Redskins while you're on that?
Sure.
Have you gotten any flack for that since you're still calling it the Redskins? And if so. What do you personally think? And you must have a comedy routine about that.
Well, I mean, we haven't received any flack as a show. I mean, I guess probably because it's our fan base that watches and supports that show for 10 years. You know, and my personal opinion on the name Washington Redskins. I don't know. I got both sides of it. I've got Native Americans who I've met who've been at Redskins Park who say. They're fine with it, but also I know there are a lot of Native Americans who aren't fine with it. It's purely a business decision, and if the Washington Redskins were to decide to change their name, I would not be affected by it one way. I would still, because I have love for the team itself and my staff and crew there, but I don't want anybody to be offended. But that's for people with bigger paychecks than me to figure out. You know, my love is for the game And I'm not trying to disrespect anybody or anything, but as it is right now, the team is the Redskins, so it is Redskins Late Night.
Well, it's an honor to have you all here. Everyone that's a part of the DMV area is excited and should be proud of this project here, because this represents us, you know, Huggy and Lowdown, Chris Paul, live DC. We have Ski Johnson here. Saxophone artist, world renowned, legendary.
Ski Johnson is DC also. He's DC.
Yes,
he's DC. Yeah, he's DC. I know he's international. I know he's coast to coast, but still.
We started at Mr. Henry's. That's where it all started.
Right.
And it's been an honor, man, when you think about that. Yeah, you was at Mr. Henry's too?
We saw you playing at Mr. Henry's, and he said, bro, put something in his cup. I said, all right.
Just real quick, I want to point out a couple things. We had invited Vincent Orange to come from the city council. He has a big initiative now that he's really pushing to start bringing entertainment here to the D.C. area. As you notice, a week and a half ago, they shot an episode of House of Cards. So there's a big kind of battle going on between Maryland and D.C. to try to attract more entertainment, more things in the music industry and stuff like that here to the area. He wasn't able to come, but he did send a representative. She wasn't able to come. I talked to her for a second because you guys were going to know.
So he sent the representative, and the representative wasn't able to come?
She was here. She had to leave real quick. But we'll follow this discussion up. Myself and Pac did get a chance to talk to
her. I mean, they just threw me for a living.
And the representative she actually is over the film and television development committee that they have set up in the city council to start attracting more. Because there's so many movies and shows that feature Washington, D.C. that are not shot here in Washington, D.C.
Right.
And a lot of it is because there's a competition with the cities because they bring so many jobs in and they offer tax incentives. Maryland offers $7 million. They put up $7 million, they got House of Cards. Last year alone, House of Cards generated over $120 million in tax revenue for the state of Maryland. So there's an active initiative now to try to bring that type of business back here to Washington, D.C. So we're not just
image. Mary and Barry back in that office.
And Mary did want, he did, Mary gave us great advice years ago when we started. He said, Huggy, Chris, always remember your lines. And then he rolled up a dollar bill.
And you see why the DVD is coming on at 1:30.
Hey, he gave me my first job, man. My first summer job.
He gave me my first summer job.
Were you working together?
Me and my father. I was my father's supervisor.
He was a junior backhand.
Actually, in Marion Barry's defense, man, he was tired, man. And he drives for Uber part-time. What are you doing driving anyway? How old is Marion Barry now? He's got to be like an octogenarian, right?
Well, he's done a lot for this
city. Yeah, he's still
active on the city council.
Right, I remember. I love him. He was going to be here, but he sent the representative. But the representative didn't show up.
Dog, boy, you set that one up, buddy. This cake, again, is...
Oh, so you can actually eat the cake.
Yeah, you can. You can you hand me
eat the cake, Anna, mate?
Hold on. Let me decide in here who I want to eat me.
Look at the camera that took it out of the thing.
Give the ladies a slice.
You see that one brother? Hey, I'll eat the cake.
I just want to get a shot of this cake.
No, it's not a rum cake.
It's really good, I heard.
It's not a rum cake. You say you want a shot of it? I got a shot. It's trying to make it roll. Oh, it's sliding.
Okay, I got my video on. I don't know why. I didn't have it.
They don't say Walmart.
It's cake. Walmart. It's a Drake cake.
Drake cake.
That's what they do. Like, just say Costco.
Ski got his name on the bottom of that ski.
Oh, hey man, I got a mark.
Product placement, right? Ski got his picture on the bottom of the cake.